Less than 2 hours after the hijacked jets plowed into both those towers, the two towers crumbled to the ground. ABC's Robert Krulwich explains why.
Why did the towers collapse as quickly and as suddenly as they did? Engineers from the original firm that built the towers told ABC they can only guess at this point, but they believe that the collisions themselves, the plane hitting building number one and the plane that smashed into building number two,
oh my God!
By themselves, they did not cause the collapse. It was the fire, they say, the intense fire and heat from the explosions that brought the buildings down. Temperatures inside could have built up to 1600 degrees Fahrenheit. At that temperature, steel loses its strength, and steel beams connect every floor to the outside walls. As it got hotter, the beams got weaker, and the hot air inside began to push and press against the outside walls until the outside walls just buckled, snapped, and released the top floor, which fell onto the floor below, and the entire building sinks in a straight vertical, the floors falling faster and faster down. Until you notice that every floor in the building is gone. Viewed from another angle, you can see the same thing. Notice the aerial stays vertical, just stays straight as it sinks into the building. There's no buckling or tipping, just straight down. And this happened in both buildings. The first tower, too, stayed straight as it went down, each floor falling neatly on top of the other. So the reason the towers went so quickly is because all the floors were literally hanging onto the skin. And once the skin went, the buildings went, too. Robert Krulwich, ABC News.